Responding to the hacktivist group Anonymous India's call for protest against internet censorship, a small group of young people staged a demonstration at the Besanagar beach last week.
Sharing is not
stealing.
Sharing is not
stealing.
Sharing is not
stealing.
Sharing is not
stealing.
Internet is
freedom.
Internet is
freedom.
Internet is
freedom.
Internet is
freedom.
Sharing is not.
Organized by the Free Software Foundation, Tamil Nadu, the protest targeted the Information Technology Act and the Copyright Act brought in by the Government of India. The protesters said that the provisions in the acts were being used to censor free flow of information on internet. What brings you here and what are you protesting against?
Yeah, basically we are protesting against the rules that has been formulated by India that curbs internet freedom, as you rightly said. What happens right now is there is something called as intermediaries guidelines rules, which allows Facebook and Google and websites of that sort to take down content without the permission of the people who are uploading the content, if that is against any such person in defamation of that person or an institution. So this is a vaguely defined concept, and this is bringing down the whole democratic process that is enshrined in the internet. That is what have brought us here, and it's also the open call by the hackers group Anonymous to protest against various measures taken by the government and other ISPs, internet service providers, in bringing down file sharing websites like Vimeo and torrents like the Pirate Bay and other torrent sites. That's why we have protested against.
In an open letter addressed to the Government of India, Anonymous India, the hacktivist group, has claimed that what it is doing is essentially a new avatar of the traditional forms of protest. Do you fully support what Anonymous India is doing?
Not exactly, but right now they're focusing on this traditional, the newer forms of protest on internet, like denial of service, distributed denial of service. That's a newer form of protest, I agree with it. But when it comes to the streets, it's all the older forms of protest, as we have come up with banners, we have come up with placards showing us like our stand on all these issues and spreading awareness among people. So it's similar to all the types of protests, of means of protest that we are employing here. So we don't agree to Anonymous in that means, and we have some reservations regarding their points in agenda, like supporting or bringing unique ID to all of them as a citizenship measure. It's a different call by Free Software Movement of India, which we are part of, and that has actually brought us here. But people from everywhere is here, like those who have responded to Anonymous call as well.
So what in your opinion would eventually be successful? A sort of online campaign that Anonymous India is carrying, or the kind of protest that you did today?
I would say that we are not against Anonymous, yeah, but at the same time we have some reservation. The best means of protest is to combine both, because this is such a niche topic, like only some people are aware of it through the internet, through the FB and through other means of internet that it offers. But rest of the people, as we saw right now, like most of the people are not aware of all these measures. So it should be a combination of both internet and the traditional forms of protest that we should be using.
While the Article 19 guarantees freedom of speech and expression, the same right is circumscribed by the Article 19(2) of our Constitution. In that context, what do you have to say about the regulations being brought in by the Government of India?
See, there is an ambiguity in that right itself. So it doesn't specify, it says just reasonable restrictions, but the grounds for reasonable restrictions are changed from time to time. And now what the government is trying to do is not a reasonable restriction, but a blanket restriction. That is where the contradiction between our stand and the government stands come. When it is a reasonable restriction, fine. That too, when it is a community-centered censorship, then it's fine. But when it is a government-centered blanket censorship, that's where the problem arises. So the right to freedom of speech and expression is getting affected there, with the blanket law which the government tries to put. That is where we are against it. That is the stand.
So where to draw the line?
The line has to be drawn by consulting with the stakeholders and not having a very, opaque governance. Government is just trying to formulate rules by its own and it will impose on the people. No, you just speak with the stakeholders. After all, we are citizens of India. After all, we are netizens. So come, speak with us, speak with the stakeholders. Then we will draw the lines. It is not going to be a zero or one binary answer.
Yes, internet is the most powerful tools of our time, but that also makes it liable to misuse. How do we guard against misuse?
Now, the problem here is it's not exactly misuse that has brought or has prompted the government to take all these actions. This is in the interest of corporates and other big players in the whole issue that has made government to act. If it's regarding a misuse of some means, then it's there everywhere. Why do you bring a blanket rule to curb all this? You don't ban the whole internet, or you don't take down the whole internet to stop all this misuse. Do you do that? No. You bring in some proactive measures and that are sensible to curb all these issues. And we don't see that happening here right now with taking down of file sharing websites.
Censorship! Sharing is not
stealing!
Sharing is not
stealing!
Sharing is not
stealing!
Say no to
censorship!
A policeman interrupted the protest, inquiring whether the group had the requisite permission. However, the issue was soon resolved and the group carried on with its protest. This is Pushkar Shivam for The Hindu.